A student fires a cannonball vertically upwards with a speed of 38.0 meters per second. Determine all unknowns and answer the following questions. Neglect drag and the initial height and horizontal motion of the cannonball. All right, so in this problem, we're analyzing a ball that is going up and down, but to answer these three questions, I think the best approach is actually to only analyze the part of the motion when the cannonball is traveling upwards. So we're going to find these five things for the rise only. All right, so to start off, we've defined our positive direction as upwards. The initial velocity, the launch velocity, is a positive 38.0 meters per second. We also know that as soon as the cannonball leaves the cannon, it's not affected by anything but gravitational force anymore, so this is a free fall problem, and the cannonball's acceleration will be negative 10 meters per second squared. Your teacher might use 9.81. All right, so next we need to find our third given. So if I just look at this first part of the problem, and my problem stops when the ball reaches the maximum height, then my final velocity is going to be zero. So I have my three givens, and I can go ahead and solve. So I'm going to start by getting the time. So the time is going to be, I can find that by doing the final velocity minus the initial velocity divided by the acceleration. Since the final velocity is zero, it just becomes negative 38 divided by negative 10, or 3.8 seconds. That's our first answer. The cannonball rose for 3.8 seconds. To find the maximum height, that's the displacement, I can do the initial velocity times the time plus 1/2 at squared. So going ahead and plugging that in, I'll plug in 38 times 3.8 plus a negative plus 1/2, excuse me, times negative 10 times 3.8 squared. And that gives me a maximum height of 72.2 meters. Makes sense that displacement was positive because the cannonball was moving upwards. The last thing I need to do is to find the cannonball's total flight time. Well, if the cannonball rises for 3.8 seconds, it's going to fall for an additional 3.8 seconds. So I can just do 3.8 times 2, and that gives me 7.6 seconds for the cannonball's total flight time. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at another problem. Once again, we're going to analyze the rise. We're going to analyze the rise only, or just the first part of the problem. All right, this one gives me a different given. It says the cannonball returns to the ground after an 8.2 second flight. So if this is 0 seconds at the launch, 8.2 seconds at the end. Now that 8.2 seconds actually is not going to go into my givens right here because we're looking at the rise only. The cannonball would then reach the height after half of this time, or 8.2 divided by 2, or 4.1 seconds was the amount of time the cannonball was rising. That is actually our first answer. Remember, check these answers as you go. So then it says, let me get my other given before I try to solve the problem. Remember, three given. All right, again, as soon as the cannonball leaves the cannon, free fall, so negative 10 meters per second squared, or negative 9.81. When the cannonball reaches the maximum height, the cannonball's final velocity is going to be zero. All right, so the next thing I can do is I can get my initial velocity. Rearranging the definition of acceleration, I can get my initial velocity by doing the final velocity minus at. Plugging that in, since the final velocity is zero, is just negative a times t. So negative 10 times 4.1. I said that negative twice, so that gives me a positive 41 meters per second. And finally, to get the maximum height, I can do delta y equals v naught t plus 1/2 kt squared. Plugging that in, I'm going to do 41 times 4.1 plus 1 half times negative 10 times 4.1 squared, which gives me 84.1, when I keep three significant figures, meters.